Hi, welcome to this workout. Today we're going to do a lower body workout that's completely knee friendly. We're not going to do any squats or lunges. All you need is an exercise mat for the floor exercises. So get ready and let's go. Okay, here you go. Starting this workout with a short warm-up. We do 5 exercises to warm up the body a little bit, and then we go over to the main workout. 10 different exercises today, 5 are standing and 5 are floor exercises. Then we have a water break and we're repeating the exercises again, and we finish with a bit of stretching. So first of all, just do a regular side step to get the blood flow going and get the heart rate up a little bit. If you want, cross and swing your arms. Just to warm up. All lower body exercises from today's workout are knee friendly. So we're not going to do any knee bends. We're just standing up or laying down and still have a good lower body workout. We're working the glutes, the quads, inner and outer thighs, all in this workout. So keep on stepping. Swing your arms, and from the steps we're going to warm up the calves a little bit and stretching at the same time. So what we're going to do is just a big step back and we roll off. So step back, roll off. So you start on your toe and then roll down and press your heel into the floor. So just make a big step and roll down, press the heel down. And the bigger you make the step, the more you feel that stretch on your calf at the end. Up. That's it. Warming up a little bit. So up. And if you have any ankle weights, you can wear them in this workout to give a little extra power on the moves we're going to do. But if you don't have it, no problem at all, because I'm the wearing the ankle bends either. So come on, roll back, press the heels into the floor, final ones, and that's it. And from the calves we're going to open the hips. So what we're going to do is knee up, rotate to the outside, make sure you feel that stretch in your hips opening up, and you don't have to open or lift high, you can just lift a little bit and then opening up. Just whatever feels good for you. Open up as far as you can. Make a step. And when you do that, keep that upper body straight up. That's it. Just step and open up. And from the hip openers, we're going to do the leg swings. And then we finish with a stretching exercise. And then we're ready. So come on, open up, just a few more, lift the knee up, rotate to the outside, final ones, on right, and that's it. And now we're going over to swing, so swing that leg up, walk back and swing. And if you can, come on your toe while you swing the other leg up. It's a little bit harder for the balance, but you're working your calf already. And swing, keep your upper body straight up. So when you swing, do not lean back, you're tipping over, and you don't have to swing real high. It's just for getting that blood in the legs and stretching up a little bit. So come on, just a few more swings, and then we finish with a stretch. And then we're starting the main workout with the 5 standing exercises. We do every exercise 50 seconds, and we have a 10 seconds rest to go over to the next exercise. So final swings. On left, and that's it. Okay, now come into a little wide stand. Feet are just a little bit wider than the hips, and then we're rolling off. Pulse it down, feel that stretch on your hamstrings, and roll up, stretch out. Make yourself long, and then roll off again. Pulse it down, when you can feel that stretch on your hamstrings, and roll up. We're going to do that one more time. Stretch it out. Roll over. Make sure your knees are slightly bent, soft knees. Pulse it down, feel the stretch in your hamstrings, and then roll up. Okay, that's it for the warm-up. Now we go over to the main exercises. 10 different ones, 5 standing, 5 floor exercises. So make sure you have your exercise mat nearby, because after the 5th exercise, we're going down. The first exercise we're going to do is a little bit about balance, but it's not the most important. So if you need, grab a wall or a table or a chair to hold on, because we're going to focus on the outer thighs. What we're going to do is side leg lifts, going to do 25 seconds on one side, and then we switch. So if it's hard to find your balance, grab something, starting with left. So your standing leg is slightly bent. Then lift that leg up. You can slightly bend that knee, you don't overstretch your leg. And just lift, hold it up a second, feel that outer thigh, and then tap. Tap. That's it. Come on, just a few more on this side, and then we switch over. So keep your upper body still, shoulders above your hips, so do not bend that upper body. Final one. And switch over, other side, lift up. So make sure you have both knees slightly bent, soft knees. And then lift that leg up. Feel that in your outer thighs and a little bit in the glute side. That's it. Come on, 10 more seconds. Find your balance or grab a wall to help yourself. It's no problem. It's not a balance exercise. Of course it is a little bit, but the focus is on the lower body today. And that's it. Okay, the next one is a single leg deadlift. So we're going to tap the floor, lifting one leg up. Starting on left, tap the floor, and come on up. So make sure that standing leg is again slightly bent. Then bend over, feeling that stretch. And you're working your glutes, your hamstrings right here. So tap the floor, and come on up. If it's hard, just have one hand on the wall. Help yourself and bend over. Okay, and switch over to the other side. Other leg is up, come on up. Find your balance if you can, otherwise, help yourself with the wall and come on over. That's it. Make sure your standing leg is slightly bent. Lift your rear leg up. And almost there, we can do one more. Tap over and come on up. The next one is for the inner thighs. So the first exercise was outer thigh swing, and now we'll swing the leg to the inside. So find the balance, lift up, lift up. Make sure your standing leg is slightly bent, and then bring that heel up to the inside, working the inner thigh up. So tap it in front, and then swing up to the inside. That's it. Come on. Find your balance or hold the wall. One more on this side and switch over. Inner thigh lift. Come on. So this front leg is slightly bent. Bring that heel up. Press the knee out and feel it on the inner thigh. That's it. 10 more seconds. Lift up. Toning the inner thighs here. Up. And we can do one more. That's it. Okay, now we're going over to the glutes. So what we're going to do is slightly bend again, and we're going to kick back. You don't have to kick high, so kick back, squeezing the glute. I will show you from the other side. So kick back, squeeze the glute, and tap. Kick back, and tap. That's the exercise. So keep your upper body straight up, so do not bend over, because then you have that deadlift move. Make sure your upper body is steady, and then kick back, squeezing the glute. And if you need to hold one hand, or in a chair or table or the wall, one more, and switch over. Find your balance, and now kicking right. Squeeze your glute. Come on, kick back. Find your balance and squeeze. Squeeze. Your standing leg is also slightly bent, don't forget. And engage your core, it's easier to find your balance. That's it. Squeeze that glute, kick back. One more. And that's it. Okay, now we're going for the quads. What we're going to do is standing extensions. So we tap, lift up, and extend. There we go, come on, extend. Tap, lift up, and then extend. Extend. And you don't lift to have to lift up high and then kick. Just lift up a little bit and stretch your leg. Tap, and kick. And kick. You can feel that in your quads. And again, standing like a slightly bend. Come on. Up, one more, and switch over. Up, and kick. And kick. That's it. Feel that in your quads. Kicking. Up. And up. 10 more seconds. And then we go over to the floor exercises, and that means we're halfway in the first round. Lift up and kick. Extend one more. And that's it. Okay, now we go to the floor. We go on our belly because we need to lift the legs up. So come on your belly. What we're going to do is lifting up, tapping out, and then back in. So lift your knees off the floor, squeezing the glutes, then tap out and back in. That's it. Up, tap out, back in. Squeeze, lift up, tap out, and back in. That's it. On your own pace, make sure you lift your knees off the mat, tapping out, working the glutes and the outer thighs here. So come on. Up. You just can stay on the mat. It's not about the upper body or the lower back. Just focus on squeezing your glutes, then tapping out. Lift up again, bring the legs in. Final ones. One more. Tap it in, and that's it. Okay, come over to the side. We're going to circle the leg from front till back, and then back. Come on, so tap it front, and tap it back. Tap it front, tap it back. Keep your upper body open, so do not bring the chest to the floor. Elbow is straight under your shoulder, and then just tap behind. Your hips are center, then lift up and tap to the front. That's it. Working glutes and outer thighs here. We do 50 seconds on this side, then we're going over to do glute bridge, and then we're going to do this circle over exercise on the other leg. So make sure you lift up, bring it over and back. So over and back, that's it. Without twisting your hips, because then your glutes are not working out. So keep your hips still and just move your leg. Final one, and that's it. Okay, over to the bridges. So lay down on your back, bend your knees, and the only thing we're going to do is pressing the hips up. So there we go, press the hips up, really squeeze the glutes, press the hips up, and then lower it down. Up, heels are in the floor, lift your toes up. So really press the heels down, squeeze the glutes up. That's it, come on, up. Squeeze, press, little pulse, and down. Up. Hold a second, really squeeze it up, and then lower it down. Up. And lower it down. On your own pace, make sure you're lifting the left hips up, squeezing the glutes. That's it. Come on. And the final 10 seconds, we're going to pulse on top. So little pulses, keep squeezing, come on. Little burner at the end. Final one, squeeze it, squeeze it, squeeze it, and drop it. Over to the other side, because we're going to circle over, but now on the other leg. Elbows under your shoulder, stretch out your leg, and there you go. Tap it front, tap it back. Front, back. Oh, a little bit to the front. That's it, circle over. Lifting up, feeling that air burn in the outer thighs and the glutes. And keep your hips still, so do not roll over front and back. No, keep it steady and still. Chest up, that's it. And tap, tap, tap. Come on, ignore the burn. Just one more exercise after this one, and then we have a water break. So come on, final 10 seconds. Tap over. Final five. Keep on tapping. One more, and that's it. Okay, roll down on your back again for the final exercise. And that's one for the inner and outer thighs. So legs are going straight up in the air. Open up and cross. Open up and cross. So bring the legs together. Feel that on the inner thighs. Come on. And up. Up. Make sure your lower back is in the floor. And if you need to, you can bend your legs a little bit. You don't have to overstretch. Just keep it slightly bent. It's the inner thighs that are working. So open up and bring your legs together. Open up, bring your legs together. That's it. Come on, final 15 seconds. Open up, bring together, work the inner thighs. Come on. Final ones. Do not quit. And that's it. Okay, now roll up. Come on and stand up because you finished the first round. Now make sure you drink some water, recover a little bit, and then I see you in the second round. We do the same 10 exercises and finish with a bit of stretching. Okay, here we go for round number two. We're starting again with the standing exercises. So if you find it hard to find your balance, then grab your wall or a chair or your table or something like that. Starting with a side leg lift and starting on right this time. So come on, find your balance and lift that leg up. Slowly lifting up and down. It's not about a fast pace. Make sure you lift, hold the second, feel that burn in the outer thigh. That's it. Come on. Feeling that in your outer glute, outer thigh. And one more on this side. And switching over. Find the balance again and lift up. We do every exercise 50 seconds. And then over to a new exercise. So come on, lift up. Keep your upper body straight up. So do not bend over to the side. Make sure you're standing still, straight up. Slightly bend that standing leg, one more, and that's it. Okay, over to the one leg deadlift. So we're going to tap the toes, and now I start on my left, so my right leg is going up first. There we go, bending over, and come on up. So make sure your leg is steady, not out of wiggling. Slightly bend, and come up. Bend over. Lift that rear leg up. And remember, if it's hard to find your balance, one hand on your table or wall, and then just help yourself a little bit with the balance. Switch over. Tap over and come on up. Slightly bend that front leg. Bending over and come on up. Lift that rear leg up. Come on. Final 5 seconds, tapping over, and the final one, that's it. Over to the inner thigh, so we're going to swing that leg in, and start with right this time, so tap in front, and lift up, lift up. Make sure your standing leg is soft, not slightly bent, upper body straight up, tuck your belly in to find your balance. And then just lift that leg up. Do not switch in with your hips. Hips are still and just lifting that leg up. That's it. Come on, kick up. Like you're kicking the ball up. One more and over to the other side. So kick that ball up. Kick. Kick. That's it. Just a few more. Come on, working the inner thighs. Toning the legs today. 5 more seconds. Coming up. And the final one, that's it. Over to the glutes, doing the kick backs. So find your balance and start with right. So kick back and tap. Kick back and tap. So really squeeze the glutes while you kick back. Tap and kick. And if you need, hold something to find your balance because it's all glutes that are working here. Kick and squeeze. Make sure you really kick hard in squeezing the glutes. Up. And one more. And switch over. Kick. Left is kicking right now. Front leg is slightly bent. Never lock it. Just a slight bend. Find your balance. And keep on kicking. Lift that leg up and press that heel back. Squeeze the glutes. Focus on your mind-muscle connection here. Up. One more. That's it. Over to the quads. Doing the leg extension. So lifting the knee up and then extend our leg. And I start on right again. There we go. Lift up. Extend. 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 That's it. Really press that heel down, lifting the toes up. And extend. Up. Feel that in your quads. If you want, you can, of course, keep it up and kick a little bit faster in that second round, if you can do it. That's it. Kick it. And over to the other side. So tap and kick. Tap and kick. And you don't have to lift that knee up really high, just a little bit, so you can kick in front. And if you can, just hold it and keep on kicking. That's it. Always find your option. Go at your own level. And that's it. Okay, we're going to the floor. Yes, we're already halfway in the second round. So go down on your belly. We're starting with that reverse lift and out taps. So lift, tap out, lift, and come in. Make sure your knees are off the floor when you're lifting, squeezing the glutes, tapping out, working the outer thighs, and then back in. That's it. Up and lift. Squeeze the glutes, tapping out, and tapping back in. Up and in. Up and in. Just go on your own pace, but make sure you lift your knees off the floor and tap out. Working glutes and outer thighs here. Come on. 10 more seconds. Tap it out. And tap it in. Over from side to side. That's it. Okay, we're going to the side. And I start circling on my left this time. So I'm going over to this side. Elbow straight under your shoulder. Lower leg slightly bent. And then bring over, tap and circle. Tap and circle. So lift up, bring that leg to the front. Tap it, tap it, tap it, tap it. Without twisting your hips too much. That's it. Your hips are still, chest is open. So do not lower down. Up. Right up. And tap it. And it's a real burner. But you just keep going. Tap it over. Tap it over. Tap it over. That's it. Come on. 15 seconds left. Don't quit. Just keep tapping. Over and over. Just a few more seconds. Keep your hips still. So do not twist over. Rolling down. Hips are still. One more. And that's it. Okay, go on your back because we're going to do the glute bridges. So press your heels down into the floor, shoulders are on the mat, and then hop, hips are going up in the air, squeezing the glutes, working hamstrings and glutes here. And press up. And press up. Really press the hips up, squeeze the glutes. So press, 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 and then lower down. Tap the floor just slightly, and then back up again. Up. Try to lift your toes up, press the heels down into the floor and squeezing the hips up. Watching towards your knees. Squeeze up and lower down. That's it. Come on. In the final 10 seconds, we're pulsing up. Small pulses, little presses up, 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 and squeeze the glutes. Final ones. That's it. Okay, release. Over to the other side for the circle overs. Elbow straight under your shoulders, chest up, hip center, and go. Tap it over, up, over. So do not roll, roll and roll, because that's not doing anything good. Keep your hips still, lift your leg up, tap it back, tap it front, tap it back, tap it front. That's it. Come on, stay strong, working out the thighs and glutes, still here, up, and 20 seconds left. Ignore that burn, just keep going. Just one more exercise after this, and then we're going to do some stretches. So come on, stay strong. 10 more seconds. Cross it over, tap it front, tap it back. Lift up, keep on lifting. Final one, and that's it. Okay, the final exercise is that fly and open up. So there we go, feet up in the air. Then open and bring the legs together, cross. Really squeeze the legs together, working the inner thighs. That's it. Make sure your lower back is on the floor. Up. Open up as far as you can because that's heavier to bring the legs back together. If you have a small move, it's easier for your inner thighs. So try to open up as much as you can and then lift your legs up. Come on, it's the final one. 20 seconds left. Up, come on, work those inner thighs. Last chance, 10 more seconds, come on. Open and close. Squeeze the legs together. Up, up. And the last one, that's it. Okay, now roll up, but stay down because we're going to do some stretches. And the first thing we're going to do is stretch out one leg or keep it slightly bent and then pull the other knee towards the chest. Make sure you sit them straight up and move over to the other side a bit. It's easier for me to watch in the camera. So come on, bring that knee up to the chest. Feel that stretch a little bit on your glute. So just sitting straight and pull that heel and knee towards your chest. Sit straight up, so do not roll back. Straight up. That's it. And now stretch out this leg and then pull the other knee towards your chest. If you can't bend that knee that much, you just can pull like this. It's all about stretching your glute. So pull that knee towards your chest and keep the knee slightly bent. It's also an option, but make sure you're sitting straight up. And that's it. Okay, now place your right leg over your left. Bend the knee a little bit. You can just have your feet next to your ankle or just closer to your knee, whatever angle you want. And then twist in your upper body and press that knee over. So the most important is that twist, and you can see stretching up the glute. And just hold it, pressing that knee down. And switch over. Left is going over your right and press that knee down, twist into the right side, up. And just feel the stretch, enjoy it, releasing the tension. And that's it, release. Now, spread your legs a little bit so you can feel a slight stretch on the inner thighs. Point your toes or just keep it up, just whatever you want. And now we're going to walk over. So make sure you're sitting straight up and then walk, 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 walk. Come and bring your chest over as far as you can. And the more you come over, you feel that stretch on the inner thighs. So try to come over as much as you can. Bring the chest closer to the floor. But keep your back straight. So really bend over and do not like this. Just stretch up and then walk over. Feeling that stretch on your hamstrings and inner thighs here. And whenever you breathe out, try to bring the chest closer to the floor. Feeling that stretch. And now walk back slowly, slowly, slowly. And bend your knees. And now we're going to stand up for the final two stretches because that's standing stretches. The first one is for the calf. So what we're going to do is a big step back. Press the heel down into the floor and the hips forward. So press the hips open, feeling that stretch on your hip and keep pressing the heel down, stretching your calves. That's it. Keep pressing it down, open up, chest is up, and switch. So bend the knee, big step back, weight left, heel into the floor, Open your hips by pressing the hips forward a little bit. That's it. Keep pressing the heel down. Feel that stretch on your glute. Oh, on your calf, of course, not the glutes. We did the glute by the sitting stretches. And come on up. We're going to do one final stretch, and that's for the hamstrings. So feet are close together, and then slightly bend the knees, just a slight bend, just a soft knee, and then roll off as much as you can, feeling that stretch in your hamstrings. So make sure the whole feet is on the floor, and then try to touch your toes. Bend over as much as you can, and most important is that you bring your chest close to your knees. You can even do that without the arms. Bring the chest close and you feel that stretch on your hamstrings. And if you can do that, try to grab your hamstrings, pull yourself a little bit closer, or your calves, and just feel that stretch. That's it. Hold it, bring your chest a little bit closer. And then slightly bend the knees and roll up slowly. And that's it. Come on, final shakes out of the legs, releasing the tension. And that's it. Very well done. You finished this lower body workout, so give yourself your well-deserved thumbs up. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know, leave a comment, and I'll see you next time in another workout. Bye.